Dear friends, this video will going to talk about what is the responsibility of Art Spring Boot application tab. There's a three primary responsibilities. One is enable auto configuration, performing component scan, and creating application context. Enabling auto configuration, performing component scan, and creating application context. So these are three primary responsibilities of Art Spring Boot application. When you go back to last project, that is a first tab, right? Yeah. The first tab, there is one class called first tab application. Okay, this first tab application annotated with Art Spring Boot application tab annotation. Okay, if you annotated like this, this is the starting point of your Spring Boot application. Okay, when you go inside this annotation class, see here, Spring Boot Art Spring Boot configuration, Art enable auto configuration, Art component scan. There are three tags are defined here. See, these two tags responsibility is configuring your Spring Boot application and enabling the auto configuration, enabling auto configuration and configuring your Spring Boot application. That is the responsibility of these two annotation. The third one is component scan. Okay, when we work with the Spring framework initially, that is 5 years back, something like that, when I work with Spring framework, I need to mention in a bean.xml file, sorry, the XML file or configuration Java file, I need to tell which package you want to scan, which package you want to scan, what is the use of scanning, component scan. In the last session, I explained about add service class, add service annotation, add component annotation, right? So this was some important annotation, add service and add component qualifier primary. So if any classes annotated with add service, if any classes annotated with add component, that classes managed by our Spring framework. Okay, now inside the first tab, I have declared some classes here. I have declared some classes. Now let's assume that those classes I annotated with add service, add component. Now I want to tell to Spring framework, hey, I have some classes, those classes annotated with add service, add component, please manage those classes in your IOC container. I need to tell that. I need to tell which package those classes exist. I need to tell that through component scan. Through component scan, we need to tell explicitly in Spring framework. But in the case of Spring Boot, you don't have to tell. It will happen implicitly. Okay, that is automatically that will happen. Under com.itgarden, whatever classes declared using add service, add component, those classes automatically scanned by your Spring framework and managed those beans in your IOC container. That is the use of add component. Okay, so your Spring Boot Art Spring Boot application responsibilities: enabling auto configuration, performing component scan. Third one is creating application context. After scanning all the beans available in your project, that bean will go into placed in your IOC container. Okay, that IOC container we can create in two ways. One is for bean factory, another one is for application context. This I explained last video session itself. For your Spring Boot, use the application context to create IOC container. Okay, your Spring Boot application, use the application context to create IOC container. All scanned bins will be placed into inside IOC container. This is the three responsibility of Art Spring Boot application annotation tag. So if any classes annotated with Art Spring Boot application That class is the starting point of your Spring Boot application. This annotation will do auto configuration, component scan, and creating a application context. Okay. Now, next you will going to see practical implementation of add service annotation, add component annotation, add configure, and primary annotation. Okay. This annotation is going to talk about in upcoming videos. Okay. This add repository, add transaction, I'll going to talk about later. When I start taking video about JPA and the DBA part, that time I'll going to explain add repository, add transaction. Now we're going to see the practical implementation of add service, add component, add qualifier, add primary. Okay. First, I want to create a one Spring project. I want to create a group name as a IT garden artifacts REST web this example of annotations REST and the web. Using this project, I'll going to cover whatever annotation I have told that I'll going to cover. After completion of that, I am planning to cover some example of REST, example of REST web services, example of web application. Okay. For that, for REST and the web, we need to add a one dependency called web. Using this web dependency, we can implement a RESTful as well as a web-based application. If you want to create a web-based application, we need to add a we should have a UI, right? HTML page. For that HTML page support, there is another dependency called TimeLeaf that we need to add. Okay, the modern server-side Java template engine for both web and the standalone environment allows HTML to be correctly displayed in the browser and as a static prototype. Using TimeLeaf template engine, we can integrate HTML page 2 in our Spring Boot application. I will cover this topic after completion of this annotation part of this video session. Okay, now I want to generate the project. By clicking generate, I can generate a Spring Boot application. I'm saving to in this folder. Once save that, go to that folder, extract this, extract here. Now I want to import this project in IntelliJ. File, new project from existing source. There is a REST web which I generated. Select pom.xml file, click OK. It will ask, do you want to open this window or new window? I'm always prefer new window to open. See here, so open. So, see the default class created. Now by adding some service classes, component classes by in this project, I will show you the annotation examples. Okay. Okay, now we're going to see the example of the annotations which are I have mixed some annotations. I need to add that at controller at test controller. Okay. Okay, these annotation examples we'll going to see now. Before that, I want to explain something. If you take any project, that project contains three layers. minimum 3 layers. We can have a number of layers as we need, but the minimum it should have a 3 layers: presentation layer, service layer, data access layer. Okay, how do you create a presentation layer? See, presentation layer, using presentation layer we can connect to the view component. View component nothing but HTML, JSPs, JSPs, then the mobile application. These are all the views, right? The client application. Using presentation layer we can connect the client application, like a mobile application, browsers, some devices. Okay, this is the gateway of the to connect our client application. Okay, how do you create a presentation layer? Using a risk controller or art controller. We have a two way to create a presentation layer. One is risk controller, another one is a controller. Another one is a service layer. The service layer we can create using at service service annotation, okay, or using at component annotation. From my understanding, both service, both component will do the same task. Okay, I don't see any difference between the at service and the at component. I will explain more about that later. Okay, then another layer is a data access layer. Using at repository annotation we can create a data access layer. Using data access layer we can perform CRUD operation. What is a CRUD operation? Create, update, modify and delete. Create, update, delete and fetch. Using we can say CRUD operation, CRUD, CRUD operation. Create, read, update and delete. This is called as a CRUD. We can retrieve the data from the database. We can store database, store information to the database. These things we can do using the data access layer. We can create a data access layer using at repository. Okay, now this is the flow. The client will contact presentation layer, presentation layer will contact service layer, service layer will contact a data access layer. Okay, now these three layers are having a dependency. Okay, the service layer always dependent with repository layer, presentation layer always dependent with service layer. Okay, inside a service layer we have some set of classes, data access layer we have some set of classes, presentation layer we have some set of classes. Now service layer always dependent with data access layer. That is, whatever classes exist in the data access layer, that class should inject inside the service layer classes. Whatever classes exist in the service layer, those classes should inject inside the presentation layer classes. Okay, how do we do that injection? We can do that injection through AutoWire annotation. Through at AutoWire annotation we can do the injection. Okay, now we'll go into see the examples. This video already became a more than 15 minutes, so I don't want to record more than 15 minutes. It might be boring you guys, so I stopped the session here. For practical example, I'll go into record separate video. I'll put that video session and link in this video description itself. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh K7. Please share this video to your friends and colleagues who want to learn Spring Boot in detail, as well as Spring Cloud and microservice in detail. Please share with your friends and colleagues. Until then, bye bye from Suresh K7.